Duxiga boarding kaya malalaha Amano. Amano boarding and a school.
Welcome to our revision final lesson. So you can see we have the timetable for the exam timetable. Just to remind you, exams will begin on 6th of June, one subject per day, and will end on 20th of June with our biology lesson. So take note of this so that you plan accordingly, do a lot of revision for your exams. So for today, we are interested in revising geography. That's what we are looking at today. So this exam is the final for the year. So it will carry everything we have been doing for the whole year. So it will be about coastal environments. So those are areas to revise for the final end of the year exam. So we'll start with our objective, just to run through what we have covered during the year. Not much. So we started with coastal processes. We look at factors that affect coastal areas, which is mainly land, sea, weather, human activity. Then, so those are the main factors that affect coastal processes. Then finally, we have physical processes are divided into two groups: the marine processes, which is to do with sea, and terrestrial processes, which is to do with land. So marine processes are mainly affected by waves. So waves affect marines or the coastal environment through swash and backwash, constructive and destructive waves, abrasion and attrition, longshore drift, which is mainly transport, and attrition is repeated, it's already there. Then, so in terms of waves, we have destructive and constructive waves. So destructive waves cause erosion. It happens through three mechanisms. The first one, hydraulic action, which means when waves push pockets of air into cracks, therefore it makes the cracks to be weak, then it leads to falling off. We also have abrasion, where waves pick up stones and hurl on the cliffs as they move along. Then we have corrosion, which is the chemical decomposition of rocks by seawater. Then next, we look at land processes. Land processes, weathering, that is breaking down of rocks through freeze-thaw. Freeze-thaw is the expansion and contraction through warming and freezing of ice. Growth of salt crystals, and also rain, acid rain, and plant roots. So they cause weathering. Erosion is through wind and rain, and mass movement happens through rock faults when there's a weakness, slumping, and also landslides, which is a mass of land moving. So some of the coastal landforms, we divided them into two. We looked at erosional landforms and depositional landforms. So erosional landforms includes headlands and bays, cliffs and wave cut notches, caves, arches, stacks, and stump. So these are erosional landforms. Then we have depositional landforms, which include beaches, spits, bars, lagoons, tumbolos, cascade forelands, and coastal sand dunes. So this is just a look at what we had done before. We also looked at factors affecting coastal environments, and we saw main factors is geology, which is the rock formation. We have hard rocks and soft rocks. Hard rocks lead to formation of headlands, and soft rocks leads to formation of things like bays. Then vegetation, sand dunes and mangroves. So sand dunes affect, vegetation affects how sand dunes are formed, and also mangroves affect the coastal ecosystem. Then sea level changes. This is because of global warming and climate change. Then we also have human activities. This is the action of human beings through settlements. People stay along the coastal areas. Economic development, say building of hotels, building of marinas, and also coastal management, which is about taking care of the coastal environment. Coastal ecosystems, we looked at the coral reef ecosystem, mangrove ecosystem, salt marshes ecosystem, and coastal sand dunes. So here it is coral reefs. So just remember, it is coral reef ecosystem. It's coral reef ecosystem. So we already looked at coral reef ecosystem, which are the threats that they face, the ecosystems. For example, coral reefs, they face threat of pollution, coral bleaching, overfishing, quarrying for coral, for building of building stones. Mangroves face problems of threats of deforestation to clear land for agriculture and also development, like building hotels, as I said before, to provide timber and also for land reclamation. Then salt marshes, they suffer threat of reclamation, industrial pollution, agricultural pollution, developments, marinas and hotels. Coastal sand dunes face threat of sand harvesting and coastal developments. Then coastal conflicts, there are conflicts between development and conservation. They need to develop and they need to conserve. So conflicts between coastal users, these are some of the coastal users, local residents, employers, farmers, fishermen, port authorities, transport companies, tourists and developers. So they also have conflicts amongst themselves. Then coastal flooding, we also looked at, is cause flooding is mainly as a result of storm surges, typhoons and hurricanes, tsunamis, that's volcano and caused by volcano and earthquakes, global warming, which causes rise in sea level. So we also looked at reducing the coastal flooding risk. So coastal flooding risk can be reduced through prediction, that means forecasting the upcoming weather patterns, and also prevention, that's building defenses and planning. Then we also looked at coastal management strategies, two main strategies, hard engineering management and soft engineering management. So hard engineering management, you can use strategies such as building a seawall, building groins, gabions, revetment, riprapps. Soft engineering involves beach replenishment, building bars, manage retreat. Then finally, in conclusion, soft engineering works with nature to protect the coast rather than trying to stop natural processes, while hard engineering involves intervention, using artificial intervention to stop the coastal processes. So basically, that's what we looked at through the lesson. So when you're revising for your exams, go through this. You already have most of them in your notes. I wish you all the best. Thank you.